YouTubers, and thank you for tuning in to the Days of Flat Toy View. Or should I say, Ni Hao, YouTubers, and thank you for tuning in to the Days of Flat Toy View. Because once again, it's going to be on the theme of Oriental slash Chinese, maybe Japanese or Korean themed toys. And strangely enough, I've got a funny feeling this theme is set to continue for a long time. But nevertheless, we've got Trackmaster. Yes, Trackmaster Luke is actually running quite nicely well. He'll appear later on, right here, I suppose. There he is there. He's got himself a new battery, of course, yes, but what's very strange about the battery that I'm using is that that's basically the same battery that I've been using, like so. Of course, yes, what's very strange is that if I show you, there's so much info on this very interesting battery. There you go, it's just an alkaline battery, but do you know what it is? Dun dun dun! Made in China! Is there any licensing info? I don't know. Well, actually, no licensing info. Of course, yes, I got a funny feeling that I possibly sound like a broken record though, because whenever you have stuff which is made in China, especially batteries, it's always a misconception. I've actually got a video talking about made in China stuff along with Club Penguin and some of the more upcoming themes, and also some of the more current themes for Flip Up Toys that I might go ahead and talk about, especially the Halloween themed toys. I'm still waiting for at least maybe two more products to be made, but we'll just wait and see as we head towards like the very near end of the month though, which is where Halloween is just around the corner. In fact, compared to 2019, I actually made a lot more origami stuff in relationship to Halloween time versus 2019, because, well, 2019 was actually quite abundant, filled with unpackaged and non-origami themed, well, Halloween themed toys. Or non-origami Halloween themed toys, actually. I should have set that one perfectly, eh? Whew. But anyways, we're going to be taking a look at a product that looks very similar to another toy product there that I've done it before. I've actually already done another Sensei Penguin before, eh? But it is there. It's called Sensei Penguins Inner Peace Fabrics and Items 5-pack, and it costs about £5.50, giving it some weird, maybe Kung Fu Panda, Teenage Ninja Turtles, or I don't know. It also gives it some weird Lego Ninjago kind of vibe. Not much info except of the components of what's inside in this toy. Yes, I think I see a couple of differences though. I know Sensei could remain the same. Maybe the hat could be in a different shade of yellow or brown though. Maybe like I'm not sure what it is. Maybe like a golden tan kind of color, eh? I believe the rug or the mat might be a bit different in color as well. Maybe the pillow might have a different lineage or a different shade of green. But anyways, let's grab the webcam because this is not going to be some kind of very weird random vlog. But I've got to be very careful because obviously where I'm actually standing, Trackmaster Luke and his layout is actually right in front of me, sir. And even right over there, there's actually curves right there as well. So I don't know what to do now. So, I don't know about you, but I'm trying to find a good place there. I can't do the bed though, because obviously it's going to make my bed a bit more manky in a sense, eh, in the way it smells. In fact, I should just actually, maybe try and review the product right over there. Oh well, let's do it then, shall we? In a sense, the answer is yes. I don't know how much space I'm actually going to be containing throughout the rest of this video because, oh my goodness me, I'm getting hammered by Trackmaster Luke and his utter layout. My god, I mean, crikeys, this is actually getting a bit too ridiculous. That's why I'm making this video on YouTube. Anyways, let's go for the impacting shot. I know, it's just a very simplistic toy product based on, you know, a bit of sensei-ness, if it's a word, eh? There you go, obviously the rug has got some very good fringiness, eh? I could have put more info onto the packaging, eh? It would have been much more nicer, I would have said, eh? Oh well, maybe I should try and update it from tomorrow because I'm just too lazy. How about that, hearing I'm lazy? Where's Sensei Penguin? I know the notable difference is that he's got closed eyes. I know the eyebrows look the same. Just a regular looking grey penguin though. No, well, what's actually quite strange is there's no beard! Crikey, there's no beard on him! Oh, great. And Trackmaster Luke, hey! Don't ever think about taking over my videos again, Trackmaster Luke! God damn it. Why does that darn train keep on taking over my videos and whatnot? But anyways, let's fit this sensei hat like so. Obviously, I think it might be a different shade of brown, maybe. There you go. Look at that. Bit different. Might be totally wrong though. Maybe it could be the same. I don't know. Maybe you guys can tell me. But anyways, let's take a look at the rug or the mat. It's got some very nice fringiness. And yes, the difference is that, yes, I've actually noticed is that the yellow in the middle though is actually a lot more, how would you say, a little bit difficult to see. It's got low contrast compared to the other mat that I've reviewed in the previous video in September. Oh my god, Trackmaster Luke! Oh god, he's going to be taking over the whole freaking video though. But you know what, it's only just going to be a 1-2 products kind of review, obviously, eh? It's the other side there looks, it's a tad brighter though, a little bit, how would you say it, a little bit more hue into it versus this one here. It's a bit more lighter and pale. But what I've also noticed is that, look at this, it's got some beautiful looking golden patterns in it here as well. Look at that, so shiny and almost glittery like, that kind of, you know, sensei matte. If you know what I mean, eh? It almost looks quite glittery. I like it. I mean, fancy that one, eh? It looks quite nice. I think the only thing I really don't like about this is that it actually looks quite a bit scribbly. If only if this was coloured in properly, it would be better. And Trackmaster Luke keeps on taking over this whole freaking video! God dang it! Anyways, let's take a look at the mat. Obviously we've already had a look at the mat, eh? Well, actually, this is a pillow. I was thinking, like, you know, cushion, or maybe like, I don't know, maybe I don't know. But you know what, it's actually quite a nice looking thing. It's often based on a piece of fabric of some kind. Well, obviously I called it a mat day because obviously, well, cushions can be, well, bed mats obviously, eh? Not mattresses obviously, eh? But please correct me if I'm wrong though, eh? Yeah, we've got the old man's stick. Oh well, let's just assemble Sensei, eh? And, yeah. Also, Sensei's got a different beak and feet kind of colorization here. I'll let Trackmaster Luke go for, eh? Because, freaking hell, he's literally taking over the whole video, eh? Oh my goodness me. Long before time had a name. The first Kojitsu Master. Alright then, I don't think I'll be able to speak and do some weird sensei impression though, because there'll be people saying, oh, but Ivan, don't do the sensei impression. Well, I won't do it for a long time, eh? Because obviously, that would actually drag the whole video on and on and on. But hopefully, we're going to be taking a look at something quite special. Remember I did a video which talked about the green Chinese dragon with the snatcher and, you know, Stan from Okage Shadow King? Well, guess what? I've actually made a brown dragon, and let me show you like so, obviously, eh? And obviously I'm going to do a hard-up comparison then. Yes, let me just put that one straight on the floor here, eh? It's obviously the same kind of dragon though, but with a very different piece of detailing, eh? Obviously it's not as well detailed as the other dragon that I did though, because obviously I think brown's quite a very hardy kind of colour. Look at that, it's got a bit lighter there on that side, but on that side it's a bit more darker, okay? So maybe it's because of the fact that that brown felt tip pen was pretty much going out of, you know, ink though. Obviously, I think in my house, brown's actually quite one of the rarest colours actually. I need to buy some more, like, you know, felt tip markers and colouring pencils and anything brown, okay? So it would have been better, I suppose, and I think brown would have helped everything. I mean, brown helps everything to keep the realism going. There you go, looking like a very feminine looking dragon here, eh? She's got like very sloppy looking eyelashes though, but she's actually got a beautiful looking blue eye on each side, and she's also got a very beautiful looking pink looking mouth which represents her lips. Crockies, that is amazing, eh? And she's got orange claws, and there's some at the bottom here, but I've actually noticed that her tail is a bit more longer and a bit much more, how would you say it? Elongo is actually a little bit more taller and longer than the other dragon that I've actually made. And here's the other dragon though. I'm actually gonna pretty much show you the direct comparison though. If I put that one there, obviously this is like my second Chinese dragon that I've just made. Okay, I've actually heard in the Wikipedia these guys are said to bring in rain, and speaking of rain, I think we're actually gonna get some thunderstorms, but am I actually gonna be totally right here? I don't know, maybe we won't have any signs of thunderstorms tonight. I might be totally wrong, but it does feel like we might get some thunder and lightning day. But it may start to look, you know. I might be totally wrong, but I'm kind of thinking that, you know, there might be some thunderstorms tonight though, eh? But I suppose it's going to be quite freaky, eh? Whenever I think about it, of course, eh? Because obviously, whenever I think of the word thunderstorms, well, it's quite freaky thinking about thunderstorms, eh? Because I would have never expected thunderstorms to occur in summertime, but it's more of a winter sort. Well, they're more absent in winter, though. It's actually much more of a summertime kind of phenomenal kind of weather, though, I suppose. I didn't expect thunderstorms to appear, though, in October, though. Because, you know, we're going to be swapping from, you know, tropical air into something completely and utterly, how would you say it, completely and utterly cold, as how seasons would normally change, though. And yes, the season we're into is October. Sorry, I didn't, you know. Let me just pretty much remove the webcam before it gets caught by the train. Oh, no. Oh, that doesn't look good. But you know what? We'll get through, eh? That's the actual computer, eh? Let me just lift it up through the top like so here. There you go, there's a bit of a comparison between those two Chinese dragons, eh? So, I've actually realised those Chinese dragons look quite amazing. And it's quite amazing. October has actually seen loads and loads of mythological creatures here, and therefore, look at that. That is totally and utterly amazing. And what I've actually noticed with this dragon is that her antlers, the brown one there, actually has a lot more of a downward kind of pose on the antlers there, whereas the male one tends to have, well, upright. It's like it's rising upwards, the yellow antlers there, or horns. I don't know why, because Chinese dragons, they're heavily inspired by, like, either deer, or maybe, like, maybe like a bovine type creature, like a sheep or a goat, or maybe a cow of some kind. But it looks quite nice, eh? And yes, the tail seems to be a lot much more. If I pretty much sit next to the green one, you can see that she's actually a little bit more longer and a bit more taller here as well, with the body and the base in it, compared with the green one right there. And look at that. That is totally and utterly stunning. How great is that? And if I sit this one here, I'm also noticing that the ears are also a little bit more larger, and are also facing that section there, whereas this one here is actually facing northwest or northeast, though, if you, depending on how you kind of view the dragon in that way. It's actually facing a bit more west, while facing a bit more upwards, I suppose, eh? Like so. And another factor is that the whiskers are also in a different kind of... I've actually realised, the whiskers or the barbels that you'd find on catfish there, on this dragon, is a little bit more like it's been swaying on the other section here as well. Let me just take a look at that. It looks like these bits here, they used to be swaying downwards there, they're actually swaying westwards there, or backwards. Which in a sense is quite interesting thinking about it here, eh? It's pointing backwards, those ears as well. And a lot more larger compared to this one here. I think I forgot to add a bit more super glue here, eh? But you know what? It's quite a nice looking model of some kind. And it looks brilliant. Let me just turn it around. Obviously, there's not much detailing going around with this dragon there, because obviously I've made it recently there, eh? Oh, wow. Hopefully this video isn't going to drag on. See what I did with the pun, eh? There you go. There's the two dragons here that I've just created, eh? And, yeah, so I got a funny feeling, eh, that these dragons look totally amazing, though. And, the back legs, though, they're actually facing a lot more vertical than, well, this one there. Okay? Strangely enough, I would have never thought that these dragons would look quite amazing. Maybe I need to repaint that section a bit more in brown, though. Because that there doesn't seem to be as bright as the other side there. Okay? But you know what? It's actually quite an amazing looking dragon, though. Very nice. Obviously, the green one's a male. And he looks quite nice indeed, too. Obviously, what's also quite interesting is that if I sit this one on top to here, you're actually noticing that the green Chinese dragon is also a lot more slimmer compared to this new brown one that I've just made, and she's a lot much more, how would you say it, a little bit more wider, and also a bit more, a bit more lively compared to this one here. But therefore, that is an amazing looking dragon. Also, the underside looks a lot more of a lemony, limey type yellow, though. Same thing with the antlers as well. That is like a very nice kind of colour. It looks great. And I've got to say that I haven't actually made quite a lot of dragons, though. Well, obviously I know I've made like a blue and gold and green looking dragon, which was like a Western Wyvern type dragon. But these two here, those Chinese dragons, are absolutely fantastic. They're certainly there to bring good luck, even during Chinese New Year. Well, yes, I have to say, with these two dragons, I'm actually quite proud in the way they've been created, though. And how's the ears? Looking nicely detailed, perhaps, though. Maybe I need to add a bit more brown into the toy. But you know what? This looks quite amazing. Well, I think that's about it in this video, eh? Before this video is going to drag on for far too long, eh? Oh my goodness me. There you go, I'm just gonna grab this one here. There. You'll be totally safe, you two, as I'm about to end this video right now. And strangely enough, no matter how much fun I must have been having with all kinds of Oriental or Chinese things, well, just say it, toys, I'm totally glad and also proud in the way I've made them so far. So anyways, if you really enjoyed this pretty interesting video, which I think is a lot much more, you know, it's actually gone a bit more better compared to the last video that I did, eh? Please give this video a like, subscribe for more flip-flap videos in the future on my YouTube channel, and as always, thank you so much for watching, and 再见, or bye-bye for now, in Chinese.